We sit here today, you and I, a day before the Republican presidential debate at the Reagan Library. This man has been canonized, deified. Ronald Reagan is the gold standard, the thing everybody running for office on the Republican side at least aspires to.
Yeah.
So as a character, couldn't really ask for a better character.
Also because such an odd life history, starting out in the movies, winding up in the White House.
Right.
And also, I'm not the first person to regard Reagan as being curiously remote, somewhat mysterious. He has defeated some biographers. I think he had Edmund Morris tearing his hair out. I mean, Edmund Morris resorted to a little bit of fictionalization. I'm glad he didn't do a whole novel, but in Dutch, which is a very interesting book, but to say the least, an odd one, because he could not grasp Reagan. He was not available. And I felt some of that as I started to write the book. Reagan is never in this book, except for the very end in an epilogue. Right. He's never seen from the inside out, you know, what's called a point of view character in the creative writing biz. He's always seen from the outside, sort of the way Gore Vidal presents Lincoln. It never goes inside him. I don't know what it says about me, but I never, in the previous book when I was writing Watergate, I never felt uncomfortable being inside Richard Nixon. It may not say the best thing about my character, but I could relate to him in a way.
Harder to access.
Absolutely, didn't attempt it. I think it had a lot to do with the way the administration operated. Everybody in any organization always wants to figure out what the boss is like, how to please the boss, et cetera. But he was so mysterious, so opaque to so many people, that I think a great deal more of his subordinates' energy went into that sort of thing than is the
norm. You're not the first to try to crack this code, as you point out.
No, no, no.
Outside or inside the Reagan circle.
Right.
Right. This is not a work of fact. It's really a work of fiction. It's historical fiction. There are a lot of real-life events and real-life It's a little bit of a literary turducken, right? Mm-hmm. It's fact wrapped in fiction wrapped in fact. It's very hard to actually read this book having lived those years and know what is fact and what is not. You've succeeded, I suppose, in crafting a story that's impenetrable with, you know...
I mean, I would say that with the kind of fiction I write that... when years go by after I've written a book, somebody will ask me about a detail. Was that made up or was that factual? And I have to go back to my notes.
If you yourself don't actually know.
If it's a fairly small thing, you know, I won't know.